Hey guys, Sherry from The Watering Mouth here. 3 super easy, super awesome eat to live prep hacks. Come into my kitchen, I'll show you. Okay, so this first prep hack is all about using a Vitamix to chop your veggies. This came in from one of my YouTube commenters named Emily, who says you can just chop them in the Vitamix. What? So she says put it on a low speed and add the veggies about a cup at a time. Just let it go until you're satisfied with the chop. The key is to not crowd the blender, she says. If you put too much in at once, some pieces will be super fine and some will be huge chunks, but if you keep the speed low and do it about a cup at a time, they come out perfect. Save so much time and make salads more doable. And she also says that she does this for her dinner veggies too, like if she makes a soup or a stir fry or something. Guys, I can confirm that Emily is exactly right. This is amazing. So I'm gonna show you how long it takes to chop mushrooms by hand, see? Or what it's like if you chop in the blender. It takes like 2 seconds. I don't know how this is gonna work with a regular blender though, so try this out. I assume it'll still work pretty well. Let me know in the comments if you find otherwise, if you've got a regular blender, okay? So you can see that you just have a few larger pieces, but to me, these are still perfect for soups or salads or anything like that. So I'm gonna put these right into my Instant Pot for some soup. Then I'm not even gonna wash the blender, and we're gonna see how long it takes to chop some zucchinis. I'm gonna do the same thing with large chunks of zucchini. It makes these perfect little fine pieces, and I just put those right into my Instant Pot too. You can see I have this big zucchini chunk left over, but that's okay. I'm just gonna put it in with the next vegetable that I chop, which is onions. This is my favorite part of the hack because onions really make me cry a lot since I don't wear contacts anymore. So I just quickly chop them, put them into big chunks, throw them in the blender, and you can see how quick this is. What I love about doing this in the Vitamix is you can direct the fumes of the onion away so you don't cry at all. And then if you take your blender over to the sink and rinse it right away, there's no more tears at all. And you can store any extra chunks into a mason jar with, guys, with a correctly labeled top so you don't accidentally use this onion top with your smoothies, because onion smelling smoothies is no good. Not that I've ever made that mistake or anything, but just a little side tip there. And then here's just a quick little bonus recipe for you to finish off the soup that I was making. I'm just gonna add some chopped green beans. I like them chopped a little bigger, so I just use my knife here. And wild rice, red lentils, low sodium veggie broth. I love the Engine 2 brand, and I threw that on high pressure for 26 minutes in the Instant Pot with a natural release. When it's ready to serve, I just add it to my cup and finish it with some tahini, lemon or lime juice, and sometimes I add nutritional yeast too, and it is so amazing. I just use everything to taste, and it is my favorite way to flavor a soup. Okay, so this next tip came in from Maria. She's in my monthly coaching membership called the Eat to Live Family. We were all swapping easy prep hacks for Nutritarian cooking, and Maria mentioned that she always makes 3 salads at a time. And I can confirm as well that this is one of the best ways to do this, because salad ingredients last for a good 3 days, even chopped up. Even tomatoes, cucumbers, things like that. So why chop every single day when you can chop every third day, right? So I didn't have a really good video of this, but I just wanted to show you that these are the typical size salads I make. This is a 2-quart bowl. And if you were to just chop 3 times as much every time, it would take you so much less time overall. And then I like to keep my big salad in these big green containers with covers on them, or you could use any other container that you like, keep it in your fridge, and now your salad eating just got so much easier. Thanks, Maria. All right, the third and final prep hack that I have for you today is to keep a jar with all of your high omega-3 seeds ground up and ready to use whenever you need them. This hack comes in from another Eat to Live family member named Liz. Guys, the Eat to Live family is my affordable monthly group coaching membership. And in here, we were talking about prep hacks. As I said, she mentions that in order to get all the nutrition from all 3 of these seeds on a regular basis, she grinds them up herself, but all together at the same time. So whenever she goes to take them and use them, she can get the nutrition from all 3 with less work, right? So here I'm showing you to grind your own flax and chia seeds and then add some hemp seeds and mix it all together. I love to do this myself now. She changed me. and I always used to just grind up flax seeds by themselves, but now I do all 3 together so I can get the special nutrition from each every day. So I'll add 1 or 2 tablespoons of this mixture to my morning smoothie, or you can add it into a soup as a thickener, things like that as well. You can add it right over your salad and get some really great fat in there. And I'm showing you here not to grind the hemp seed together, but it works just as well to grind all 3 at the same time.
and I just use a plain old KitchenAid coffee spice grinder. So you do want to make sure that you grind your own seeds in this way and don't buy things pre-ground from the store, because oftentimes if you buy them pre-ground, they can go rancid quicker. Grinding them fresh ensures better outcomes. And you do want to make sure to grind your chia seeds every time you use them so you can get the full nutrition out instead of whatever will just pass through your digestive tract undigested, okay? So I love to keep it in this container in the fridge and just scoop it out when I need it.
How about those hacks, huh? Did you know any of those? Let us know down in the comments below. Did you know those ones already? Do you use them, or do you have any way to sort of expand upon those? Do you have any hacks that you love? Let us know down below so we can share our amazing healthy eating knowledge with each other. I'd love to hear that from you. And guess what? Super, super fun, exciting announcement. There is something new that we're doing this time, which is a free 5-day eat to live challenge. And I want you to get in on it, because I'm gonna show you exactly how to make this food, make enough of it so that you're not super hungry, but that so you might even lose weight. We get so many people that lose weight on our challenges as well. But you're gonna at least come away with understanding how to put together a full day's worth of eat to live meals and not be super hungry. It's gonna be super easy. We're gonna do all the thinking for you. We're gonna give you grocery lists, meal plans, all that kind of stuff. So you're gonna know everything. You don't have to think of a thing. And this first ever 5-day challenge that we're doing is starting in just 2 days, I think, from the publish of the video, something like that. So make sure you sign up right away, because you're gonna have to do some grocery shopping, get your stuff together. If you miss this one, don't worry, we're gonna do more of them, but just continue to sign up at the link either down in the description below or maybe up above you'll see a link. Sign up there even if this one is already passed or if you are getting in a little bit late, because they're so easy to do. I want you to sign up because we're going to do so many of them in the future too. We always do these challenges. They're so helpful, so useful to get on track with Eat to Live. We want to see you in one of those challenges. So make sure you join. These are free now. The 5-day challenges are totally free. So you got to get in on this, but you have to sign up in order to join. Okay, so we hope to see you in there. I hope you like this video, and we'll see you in the next one.